natin dito sa Kababayan Today ang director na si Marie Jamora. Hi, Marie!
Hello!
So, lumaki ka ba dito sa Amerika? Kasi... O, sa Pilipinas?
Sa Pilipinas.
Sa Pilipinas! Okay! So, saan ka pinanganak sa Pilipinas?
Sa Quezon City, or QC, for those
QC. And you went to school before going to take your MFA in Colombia. You basically grew up sa Pilipinas, di ba?
Yes. So, I went to a lot of schools. So, first, St. Paul, Pasig, Catholic school. Mm-hmm. Then, second, International School of
Nag-IS
Manila.
Nag-IS ka?
Nag-IS ako. Mm-hmm. And then for middle school, 7th and 8th grade, tapos nag-ICA, which is Immaculate Conception Academy, which is a Chinese school.
Mm-hmm. Marunong ka ba mag-Chinese? Konti?
Di na eh.
Hindi na? Oo. Hindi na.
Okay. Budong, that's I don't understand. That's all I know. Or Wobaba Isyong, which is my dad is a doctor. That's all I remember.
Because your dad is a doctor.
Because my dad is a doctor. That's all the two words I just need to know.
Okay.
And then I went. Tapos nag-Ateneo ako for college.
And what did you take up in Ateneo?
Communications.
Communications. Okay, so growing up in the Philippines, starting to work in the industry at the age of 16, what do you see that are starkly different from the way things are done here and the way things are done in the Philippines?
The industry dito sa LA, I think, is so huge mm-hmm. that it's really hard to stick out. Especially, you know, because here, a hot word is diversity.
Yes.
And things like that.
And you're a female, di ba? Babae pa.
Babae, Southeast Asian, director. But it's still very hard because unless I think you know somebody really who's there who will give you a break, parang Pilipinas din actually. Kasi in the
actually,
Philippines...
Actually, oo, di ba? Kailangan may kakilala ka. May tito, may tita. Uy, kilala mo si ganyan, di ba? Here, it's called a referral. And I know this for a fact. Like, you don't cold call someone and say, "Hi, I'm G. Donji, and I'm an actress, and I really want to work with you," you know?
You can do that, but
it doesn't...
you look crazy.
Yeah. It seems to me that being that our training was in the Philippines, how does that help us with our work here?
Being hardworking. I think yung work ethic natin sobrang okay.
Kasi go lang, di ba? Yeah. Game.
We're competitive as, you know, as Asian women, I think. Always overachieving.
Tama.
And at the same time, the yung English-Filipino factor, like you can speak Taglish, but the fact that we're so proficient in English works to our advantage because people, they tend to, they're at ease more versus them feeling that they're not being understood. Because, mm-hmm. for example, I was at this panel for NYFA and there were a lot of Asian students and they were pitching their stories. And a lot of them were from China or Taiwan, Korea. And there's really a language barrier.
Yeah.
And you could see from the teachers who are American to the students, there is this like, nahihirapan sila ng konti. But with us, parang they're like, oh, she grew up here. Like, that's what they assume when they hear the way we speak. Because mm-hmm. everyone you in school sa Pilipinas, you learn in English.
Mm-hmm. You know? That's the thing what people don't understand, di ba? Sasabihin nila, oh, galing kang Pilipinas, ba't English ka ng English? Mm. The medium of instruction was in English,
yes.
Diba?
Yes.
And so now, na nandito tayo sa Amerika, I find myself every time I see a Filipino, oy, mag-Tagalog naman tayo.
Oh, kasi miss ko na yung Tagalog, diba?
Oo, kasi hindi mo talaga napapractice. At totoo, kapag hindi ka nagpapractice, nawawala, nabubulol minsan, yeah. Diba? Yung dila ko minsan. Dito sa Kababayan Today, medyo sablay. Diba? So, yes. Kailangan talagang mag-practice. Okay, so for a Filipina woman who's trying to pursue her passion of being a director, a storyteller, what do you have in the works that we can look forward to?
Well, I have a script that we've been writing since last year, which got into the LA Asian Pacific Film Festival. Mm-hmm. It was their film market. It was called Project Catalyst. And so we've been developing that and trying to find like actors or money and things like that. But I'm still working on the script. I'm not 100% happy with it mm-hmm. right now, but I think it's in a really good place. I'm developing a television show sort of based on this novel, that unpublished novel that my brother-in-law has written, Scott Garceau of the Philippine Star. He's an amazing writer.
I actually had the amazing opportunity to meet your brother-in-law because we went to London.
What?
We went to London.
Wait, which London trip was this?
We went on a press junket and
Was this a Game of Thrones?
Not that one. We went to watch Stomp. He was the one who said, you have to watch Let the Right One In on stage. And I was like, what is Let the Right One In? Oh, you got to see the original film. And I didn't know. So it's amazing the degree of separation. And of course, your sister also is a theater actress.
Yes.
In the Philippines, diba?
So, and I see you a lot because of Jenny.
Yes. I've been able to work with your sister, Jenny Jamora, who is an amazing actress.
Thank you.
Amazing.
She's in the film, too.
Yes. She was one of the sisters, diba?
Yes.
So this film is coming out on DVD soon.
Yes.
Okay. When we come back here on Kababayan Today, pag-usapan natin ang Nawawala coming to DVD very soon. Huwag po kayong aalis. Dito lang po yan sa Kababayan Today.